And we're going to do a presentation for our apostle. Before the first lady, apostle, would you stand down there with her, please? Donovan, I need you, son. Glory to God. Amen. We wasn't able to do it last night because Bingo was moving fast and quick, but we had wasn't ready. So now it's ready. Amen.
Amen. Apostle and prophetess, it just laid on my heart is to try to do something special just to show you just how much the Church of the New Beginning love y'all.
Amen.
And how we love coming down here to fellowship
Amen.
With y'all. You, your smiles are so precious. You remind me of my father. Anyway, I'll tell you that. So I want to present this to you on behalf of the Church of the New Beginning. We stole your picture on the So, we hope you enjoy time. Amen. Yeah. Time.
You'll never be late,
Pat.
You'll never be late.
Amen. We love you. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. We just thank God. Amen. And that was done by hands by design. Amen. My wife did that there. She started her own company in these areas here. So if anybody want to reach out to her, you're welcome to. Amen. Glory to God.
Amen.
That is beautiful. That's wonderful.
Amen.
Get your Bibles in the book of Galatians. Chapter 11, 6. Father, we thank you for your loving kindness and your tender mercy. Now, Jesus, we want you, amen, to continue to be in the midst of us. Them that have an ear, let them hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. And we give your name glory and praise in Jesus' name. Amen. The sixth chapter of the book of Galatians, verse number 7 and 8. And when you have it, amen. If it's not your custom and our custom, we stand for the reading of the word of the Lord. And it reads, 6 and 7, be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever man sows, that shall he also reap.
Yes.
For he who sows to his flesh shall also of the flesh reap corruption. But he who sows to the Spirit shall of the Spirit reap life everlasting. Look at your neighbor and grab your neighbor by the hand and ask your neighbor a question. Say, neighbor,
neighbor,
I really want to know what type of seed are you sowing? You may be seated. We're an hour now, sisters and brothers.
Yes.
Paul writes to the church of Galatians. He shares with them in the first verse in chapter number 6. He talks about restoration. Amen. He talks about restoration because now, amen, we're in an hour now that if a man be overtaken in a fault, we that are spiritual, amen, ought to restore such a one. We are our now, amen, that we have become, amen, a little shaky. Because now we love you on Sunday, but after service is over, we're running you down like a dog. Oh, we speak in tongues. Amen. We speak in tongues. Amen. And we run around the church. Amen. But we can't get along with the sister or the brother that we fellowship with while we was in the midst of the sanctuary. It's strange, amen, that all of us in here carry positions and titles, amen, and we got a nerve to say, I can't get along with you. The Bible said we should be able to get along with everyone, especially them that in the household of faith.
Yeah.
We ought to be able to get along with our sisters and brothers, those that are naming the name of Jesus. And when we restore them, we don't restore them by telling them, I told you so. And we're in an hour now that all of us in here made some mistakes.
Amen.
Some of us, amen, if you look close enough, God hid you when he should have uncovered you. But God's grace, amen, sustained you, amen, right in the middle where God should have pulled the covers off of you. And you ought to thank God for the grace of God. Because it wasn't your education, because a lot of educated folks are falling down. It's not because you know the Bible from Genesis to Revelation, because you can know the word and don't be a doer of the word. Because you can know something, amen, but how do you know a lot of folks know stuff, but they don't do what they know? To a place in ministry now, amen, that we that are deep and spiritual and love with God, when we find our sisters and brothers that are weak and going through, we don't, amen, hold a sign, a picket sign up, or boycott them from the service of God. But we should, amen, gladly restore them and pick them up. Look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, somebody pick you up.
Somebody picked you up.
You ain't always been who you were. Somebody had to pray for you. Somebody had to bring you from the guttermost to the uttermost. Problem because I'm in an hour now that I'm tired of folks jumping from one church to another church. Because we're an hour now that ain't not all we doing is some of our churches is recycling the saints. Because soon as you get mad with me, then you go to somebody else and get mad with them and then you go to somebody else. But ain't not happening to know that it's time for us to get out in the vineyard because the harvest is ripe, but the laborers are few. Stop your neighbor and tell your neighbor, you got to restore. And he told you about the characteristics of restoring. You got to restore with a spirit of meekness. And in order, consider yourself, amen, lest you be tempted. Because, amen, you got to understand that the same measures you get out to somebody else, you yourself is going to be measured by the same, amen, stuff that you dish out to somebody else. Tell your neighbors that you better be careful what you say to somebody else, because what you say determines what's going to happen to you. Oh, do I got a witness in here?
Well.
You can't say one thing then do another.
Yeah.
You can't tell me, amen, I'm with you and then you're not with me. Do I got a witness in here? If you're going to be who you are, you got to be the church. If you're going to be the church, be the church. High five your neighbor. Tell your neighbor, say, if you're going to be the church, you got to be the church. Amen, that we are the bear of one another's burden because we fulfill the law of Christ, and Christ's law is love. The Bible said, for a man think he something, amen, when he is nothing. Because a lot of folks walk around like they got it going on. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me over here. And some of y'all think y'all already have arrived. Because even myself and some of these great giants in the kingdom have not arrived yet. And you got to be careful that you don't get too lifted, amen, that God can't use you. Do I got a witness in here? One thing I don't like an arrogant preacher. Do I got a witness in here? I don't like arrogance. Amen. It's a difference between being arrogant and being confident. Do I got a witness in here? And we got too many little arrogant folks walking around every area and think they can fall. But I've seen a whole lot of arrogant preachers, amen, rise to the top and then wind up falling. Look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, you better stay humble. The Bible said, because that man deserves
sees himself. When you think you are better than the person, amen, that you're trying to restore, you deceive yourself. Why don't you preach over it? I plan to. Tell your neighbor, say neighbor, that the devil is a liar. Adam said, but let every man prove his own work. Then shall he have rejoice in himself alone and not in the other. Because a lot of times we do things where a person fall, and then we want to rejoice over them and tell them, I told you so. Well, I got a witness in here. Instead of saying, I'm going to pray for you, sister. I know you slipped. I know you messed up. I know. Amen. You got weak along the way. But I'm going to help a brother out. I'm going to help a sister out. High five your neighbor. Say, I'm going to help you through this. So help me, God. But if you don't mean it, don't say it. Well, I got a witness in here. I'd rather for you to be truth with me than to talk to me and be two-faced. Well, I got a witness in here. Oh, I'm tired of two-faced. The folks smile and grin in your face and ride on a Hyundai, but don't really got the love of God on the inside. I know I ain't got much help in here. I know y'all want to dance and shout, but can I preach in this place? I find your neighbor and tell your neighbor, say, where's your real love?
Where's your real love?
Sisters and brothers, we are out now. Amen. That every man should bear his own burdens. Let him be taught in the word and communicate unto him who teaches in all good things. But Paul says there's two types of people. That one that sows discord among the brethren. That one that goes out and gives false information and false doctrine and false teaching. You got to be careful because you got to understand. I got a problem with this. And I've been in church a long time. I come from a line of preaching. Amen. You know, grandfather was a preacher, evangelist. I come down the line of preaching. And I found out one thing that we got to be careful because there's a lot of false prophets just on the scene. Come on, can I talk back to y'all? You know, after service, if you ain't got all you want to get from God, then there's a wonder that sits right in the middle of your service and want to rub you down with baby oil. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me up here. Be ready to get you in the bathroom and give you a word, but it's not a word from the Lord. And so Paul said, you got to be careful because they mock, amen, the power of God. Come on here, somebody. The Bible said they have a form of godliness, but deny the power thereof. Y'all ain't gonna talk back to me up in here. If I prophesy in the house in the car, and you got a mansion over here, y'all be screaming. Well, I got a witness. But I'm trying to help you and to save you from the adversary, which is the devil. He comes to kill, steal, and destroy. Jesus said, I come that you may have life and have that life more abundantly. Squeeze your little by your hand and said, the devil is alive. Paul says he's speaking primarily to the believers. He's telling the believers now, you got to be careful now. False teachers that move you from the faith and from the cross. Because you got to understand how they come in creeping in to move you from what you believe in. You got a witness in here. You know Jesus saves. You know Jesus delivers you. You know Jesus here. You can't afford to allow strange, erroneous gospels to come up in your life to try to move you from the faith. And your neighbor say, there's power in the blood. Oh, I know it's power in the blood. Let God have to me like Jesus. Squeeze somebody by the head and tell your neighbor, say, can nobody do me like Jesus. Say they come because now they want to mark of God. They come, amen, as substitutes. They come, amen, to try to replace cross. But at the cross when I first saw the light and the burden of my heart rolled away. Well, I got a witness in here. Tell your neighbor, say, was that a cross? Well, I got a witness in here. The Bible says, they come sowing amen, I'm failing gospel. They come. We claim conversations. They come with a plan to try to destroy you. They come because they come in the flesh. And when they come in the flesh, they bring a spirit of corruption. Can I preach in this place?
Well.
You got to be careful in this hour that you don't leave the faith. They come with a spirit of corruption. They're trying to destroy you and bring you down.
Well,
look at your neighbor, just like said, the devil is alive.
Well,
sisters and brothers, but they who sows in the spirit shall of the spirit reap everlasting life. There's an order about God. These things must come by fasting and prayer. You can't do spiritual things in the flesh. Why do we miss it here? You can't do God's working in the flesh. But you got to have Christ on the inside, which is the hope of glory. Squeeze your neighbor by the hand like you're going to shake it off and say, neighbor, oh neighbor. If you're going to live for him. And don't let nothing and nobody separate you from the love of God. You didn't pay the price to be in Christianity. But allow the enemy to play with your mind. The Bible says, let this mind be in you. Let's also in Christ Jesus. Don't let the devil steal your mind. You got to be settled. You got to be grounded. You got to be rooted. You got to witness it. Tell your neighbors a neighbor.
Oh,
neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Say, you got to witness it. It's Jesus in the morning. It's Jesus in the noonday. It's Jesus when I lay down. It's Jesus when I rise. You got to witness it. Shall confess that Jesus is alive. fix it. You can't fix it.